Dear ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the 26 partners of Poseidon 2, I would like to welcome you to our event. Dear Minister, Mr. Plekotakis, dear Mayor, Ms. Piraeus, it's an honor for us to have you here among other distinguished guests. Your presence here reaffirms the support of the Greek government and the European Union on our efforts on the Poseidon Maritime project for a cleaner and greener future in shipping. Especially, I would like also to thank the chairman and the vice chairman of Piraeus Port Authorities, the biggest port of the country and of the whole area, for hosting our event and for being a very active member of our consortium. Also, I would like to give a warm welcome to the participants of the shipping industry for being here to support our event, proving that this green marine community is big and will become even bigger. Our event coincides with the start, with the beginning of the new era in the international shipping, with the application since January 1st of this year of the new IMO environmental regulations. In this changing and challenging together environment, LNG is expected to play a very important role. In this framework, we, the 26 partners from three countries, Greece, Cyprus and Italy, are intensively working together for 4 years now under the consortium of the EU co-financed Poseidon Maritime project, developing important synergies and promoting a competitive mix of investments that will change the marine environment in the East Med area to a low-carbon future. Since we are currently moving towards the end of Poseidon Maritime journey and all our activities are in full development, there is a wide interest from the marine industry, both public and private bodies, energy companies and many other players for the outcomes so far and the overall progress of the project. To establish a viable, efficient and sustainable LNG supply chain for marine use in the East Med, several actions have already been implemented in the framework of Poseidon Maritime. More specifically, important studies have been concluded, conceptual design, safety, preliminary environmental and supporting engineering studies for the construction of small-scale LNG bunkering infrastructure at the five ports involved in the project: Piraeus, Patra, Igoumenitsa, Heraklion and Limassol in Cyprus. The master plans for the ports of Piraeus, Patra and Igoumenitsa have been updated and approved so as to include bunkering infrastructure and operations, while on the way is the approval of the master plans of Heraklion and Limassol. All the design studies for the construction of a small-scale LNG jetty and the truck loading station at the Piraeus LNG terminal have been completed, while the tendering process for awarding the construction of the truck loading station is in progress by DEPA. Poseidon Maritime had a key contribution to the amendment of the regulatory and legislative framework for the implementation of safe LNG bunkering operations in Greek ports, established through the Presidential Decree 64/2019. Conceptual and detailed designs for the retrofitting of 10 conventional fuel vessels to LNG power vessels, as well as design studies for two new builds, have been finalized. Cost-benefit analysis were conducted for all the onshore and offshore infrastructure. to optimize the LNG bunkering and logistic cost, taking into account synergies with other energy sectors, such as the supply of with natural gas of neighboring urban networks or individual industrial users, especially in Western Greece, Patrae, Dumenitsa and in Cyprus. Based on Poseidon network results, the development of basic infrastructure for the use of LNG as marine fuel in the East Med is underway. LNG bunkering infrastructure will be available at the Venice port, the port of Piraeus in Greece and the port of Limassol in Cyprus. More specifically, under Poseidon Net 2, the construction of an innovative LNG bunkering park for the Venice area is going to be completed by the end of this year, promoting the use of LNG in Italy. Additionally, under another EU co-finance program, the Blue Caps Action, two LNG bunkering vessels of approximately 3,000 cubic meters each will be constructed and delivered by 2022. The vessels will be based one at the port of Piraeus and the other at the port of Limassol. The Greek vessel, which is developed by DEPA, has already secured its complete financing, ensuring together with the necessary small-scale LNG infrastructure at the Erythusa LNG terminal the availability of LNG bank for bunkering at the main port of the country and the whole region. IMO 2020 is now a reality and can be considered more or less as a tsunami impacting the whole shipping industry, but also the entire maritime ecosystem and beyond. But at the same time, there is a long list of additional environmental measures which may be decided in the following years. For instance, greenhouse gas emissions will predominate this discussion until up to 2050. So the main challenge for ship owners in the following years is to comply not only with the existing, but also with the future environmental regulations. LNG is the most reliable long-term solution towards this direction. Poseidon Net 2 is the cornerstone for the creation of this new market for natural gas, in line with all recent developments, preparing also the East Med to run on the LNG era. Again, on behalf of all partners of the Poseidon Net 2 project, I would like to thank you all for being here and for your valuable support. Thank you very much.